As the war in Gaza continues to escalate, the first group of civilians in Gaza have been evacuated to safety. And while there's relief for those who made it, grave fears remain for those trapped in the conflict zone.
Making a break for safety. 20 Aussies among more than 300 foreigners and dozens of injured Palestinians, including children, allowed to escape Gaza via Egypt's Rafah border crossing.
I'm not happy at all. That's because I'm leaving my other part, my brothers and sisters, my whole family is still here.
Facing impossible choices, others were forced to stay.
They said, no, you can't pick what in you. You can go, my wife has to stay. I just couldn't leave my wife behind. No, I can't leave my wife behind. She's my wife.
Concerns held for the 65 Australians still trapped in Gaza.
There are still Australians in Gaza. I know how distressing this situation is for them. Please be assured we will continue to press for all of you to cross the border out of Gaza.
It's a nightmare, believe me. It's a boring nightmare. No food, no water, no electricity, no fuel, no bread.
The evacuations come as Israel continues its ground invasion, drawing condemnation for a second strike on Gaza's Jabalia refugee camp, which Israel claims killed a senior Hamas commander.
The Secretary General is appalled over the escalating violence in Gaza, including the killing of Palestinians, including women and children, in Israeli airstrikes in residential areas of the densely populated Jabalia refugee camp.
The unprecedented humanitarian crisis in Gaza worsening by the day.
Medicine is running out. Food and water are running out. Fuel is running out. The streets of Gaza have started overflowing with sewage. A further breakdown in civil order will make it extremely difficult, if not impossible, for the largest UN agency in Gaza to continue operating.
Ayman Qwaider is watching the horror half a world away in Perth. He lost his sister and nieces in an airstrike on their home in Gaza. Ayman, first of all, how are you coping at the moment?
To be honest, this is a very challenging question to know how I'm coping. I don't know, honestly, how I'm coping, given the ongoing atrocities and the fact that my entire family is unsecure, being under the bombing, like the 1.2 million Palestinians who are still enduring this unprecedented bombing campaign from land, sea, air. It's really challenging, and I'm so anxious, I'm so concerned, I'm still grieving, I'm still mourning. So mixed kind of feeling about what's exactly happening in Gaza and for my family, my people. It is probably the toughest time in my life.
Ayman, your sister that tragically lost her life in the airstrike recently, what was she like?
My sister, Ala, 34 years old, a mother, a loving mother of three children. Ayman was 5 years old. She was actually killed in her fifth birthday. Faiz, who was 4 years old, and Sara was 7 months old. They were all killed alongside 14 members of the of her family-in-law. Only my brother-in-law, her husband, was able to survive. And he survived because he was outside in the community trying to find food to put on the table of his little one. And the whole family obliterated in the way he was back to find the whole house destroyed, and he's lost his father, his wife, my sister, and his children, his two sisters, his brothers. Like, he lost every single member of his family, basically. My sister, Alaya, is an educator, is a teacher in Gaza. She's the oldest in my sisters. Very kind, very caring. She's always has like a dreams and ambition and, you know, desire to do something in this world. She's a very proud teacher. You know, she used to send me this certificate of accomplishment when she's invited to be honored as a teacher of the year, for example, in her school. You know, we lost a teacher that is, you know, an educator for generations in Gaza and in Palestine. Mm-hmm. It's a tragic, and, you know, we're still in shock. I can't believe she's gone, to be honest. And mm-hmm. And I can't feel for my dad who broke. You know, I've never seen my dad cry in my entire life. And when we lost my sister. It was the first time, probably in my life, to see my daddy crying. So I saw how broken he was.
Ayman, we can't even imagine the horror that your family is going through at the moment, but we do appreciate you taking the time to tell us about your story. Thank you for joining us, and our thoughts are with you.
No problem. Thank you for having me.